So I'm always roasting natural hair YouTubers, natural hair community and stuff. But this time, I think it's time we talk about natural hair brands and stuff we've been letting them get away with for way too long. Natural hair brands, leave this kind of stuff in 2020, please, because we fed up.
Trini Girl Natural.
Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. This is not a roast this year. It's more of a definitely things to leave in 2020. It's not gonna be about YouTubers this year. I hit them last year, I hit them the year before, but I feel like they've been hit enough this year especially. And I do feel like we've been letting natural hair brands get away with a lot, possibly too much. And I do feel like some of that needs to change. So we'll see how this video goes. It's not gonna be a ha-ha, but let's see how upset I get. But let's see how calm I remain. So this year was a bit of a trying year for me. As you guys know, if you're subscribed to my channel, I did have a lot of hits. Definitely Ujui, Gorgeously Kinky and She Scented, but I had a lot of misses also. I had products with no slip. I had gels that were water, super stripping shampoos, leave-ins that didn't penetrate, flakes galore, flakes, flakes, flakes everywhere, and I usually don't get flakes. They were just flakes all over this year. 2020 definitely did me wrong with trying out products. It got me thinking about natural hair brands and just the state of the industry, the state of the union between natural hair consumers, brands, influencers, and everything. So I decided to come out and do a general video about it. What advice can I give to these natural hair brands? No names will be called except one or two. Let's put it that way. Things that I've observed from natural hair brands pretty much from the beginning, but that really we need to leave in 2020 and let's try to do better for 2021. Number one, low quality products in general, like products that were just low quality from jump. The no slip, no moisture thing. Can we leave it in 2020? Natural hair product makers, natural hair companies, natural hair brand owners. Can we see slip and moisture? Just for me, just for me. Can we see slip and moisture in 2021, please? At least give us those two baselines for 2021. Is that unreasonable? I don't think so. I understand you're trying to put out a line, but how are you gonna put on a line without moisture? And I can understand if one person finds it's not moisturizing and everybody else loves it, but how are you gonna put out a line and nobody finds it moisturizing? Like, do you have like a test group? Do you test on different textures? Like, what really happens in the background when you are developing a product? Like, I want to know, like, I want y'all to come and tell me, because everything I'm asking, like, I'm really seriously asking. Like, how are you going to put out a product and nobody thinks it's moisturizing? How do you test your products to see if it's moisturizing? Are you just testing on your own hair? Are you testing on your family? Are you testing on, you know, all the different textures and to at least try to get some assurance that it's going to be moisturizing? Like, that's the baseline. Like, if a product isn't moisturizing, it's really not good for much as a natural hair product. The second big one is slip, especially for like the tighter curls, but pretty much all natural hair. Like, if you really cared about our hair and not having it break off, like, it would be nice if all products had slip. And I know you know how to add slip. I know you know which ingredients give slip. So what is the difficulty with just adding some of them? Like, why is that hard? Like, you know, slippery elm, marshmallow root, silk protein. Like, what is the difficulty with adding some of these things? Let me know, because I want to know why you're not doing it. And I understand that some products don't need slip, for example, shampoos. Even masks, I guess you can section and just put it on and don't try to just smooth it or something and don't try to detangle with it or rake it through. But you know, a lot of naturals finger detangle, a lot of naturals want to rake through products. A lot of naturals need to keep detangling as they go to make sure everything stays in place. So it's really doing a disservice to all of them when you're like, okay, my product just ain't gonna have slip. Don't even worry about it. No slip. I can't decide if it's worse to say it on the label or if to not say it. Of course, I guess it's worse to not say it and then have you surprised. It should be like, warning, this thing in hand, no slip at all. But sometimes I even see that on the label, I'm like, so you're letting me know that you couldn't be bothered to add slip to this? And I can understand if it's a product that doesn't typically have slip, like some kind of herbal treatment or clay treatment. Even micro treatment has slip there, but I mean, I can see it. But how are you gonna have like a cream product without slip? That concerns me. That's bothersome. I don't understand your reasoning or how you could be content with putting out something like that. And some of y'all don't want to add ingredients for slip, but you're certainly able to add ingredients for definition in shampoos and stuff. I'm seeing y'all. I see y'all. I saw when that trend started. I remember exactly noting, okay, why the shampoo? How curly fining ingredients? And some of them bold to actually put it like curly fining shampoo, which is here nor there. Like if your shampoo curly fining and it has slip, great. If your shampoo curly fining and it has moisture, great. But I noticed that a lot of brands are putting in curly fining products to make people think that the product is moisturizing when it's not moisturizing. And I can tell on my hair when you did that because my hair just feels stuck together and it doesn't really feel moisturized. So you might be misleading some people, but other people are like wise to your game. So let's just leave the gimmicks and the shenanigans in 2020. Let the moisture do its thing with the curls. And let the whole hold what the moisture did. Like that's how it's supposed to work. I don't want to just have glued together, tangled, dry hair, okay? Inconsistent product quality, especially for sales, Black Friday sales. I had no less than 3 products from 3 different brands that came out with pretty much water in the bottle. Like 3 products from 3 different brands. That really says to me that something needs to be done in terms of quality control. And I've heard from other people as well who got something different, who got the same thing, who had similar experiences with other brands. So kind of across the board, especially the smaller brands, handmade and stuff is great, but there also needs to be some quality control. I don't know how you can know that your product is supposed to be, and then you said, how you can know your product is supposed to be one texture instead of a completely different texture. Like, where is, I don't want to say where's the pride, but if it's handmade, you put your hand on it and you see every single one, right? So how does that work? Like, how does that happen? You can feel free to explain it to me in the comments, but that's one thing I think we need to leave in 2020, like inconsistent quality on natural hair products. The bigger the brand gets, the lower the quality of the product. And just in general, the newer products coming out for a lot of brands are lower quality. A lot of times they're even taking their existing products and changing, like swapping out the fancy oils, putting in cheap oils, removing Ayurvedic herbs, and they're not even reducing the price. They're like same price, but we're gonna cheapen the quality of the product. And that is really kind of sad to see. They wanna be more in line with the FDA and so on. And maybe they can explain it to me here too, but I don't think that the FDA really prevents you from even at least using fancy oils. I'm not even talking about extracts, because extracts can be hit or miss in terms of standard and so on. I don't think the FDA really cares if you are using argan oil or if you're using sunflower oil, you know? I don't think FDA will really get on you for that. And those are some of the substitutions I'm seeing. So I think in 2021, let's stand up for what we want for your own brand and for your consumers that you love, like your sisters. Stand up for giving them quality products, products you believe in, natural products, products that are healthy for them, and products that will really benefit their hair to the max that you can give. Like, that's what I want to see in 2021. I don't want to see any formula changes where the product goes south after 2020. It's getting harder and harder to find like botanical new gels lately. That hurts me. I find it a little concerning, because back in the day, Kinky Curly, Uncle Funky, Camille Rose, like it was really easy to find a botanical gel that defined my hair and held my hair. Now most of the new gels have plastics in them, so I prefer to use a gel without any carbomer and stuff like that, just personally. I noticed most of the new gels are basically souped up Eco Styler. I do find some of them to be overpriced, and I do find it a little bit sad that botanical, organic, natural type ingredients are just buzzwords more so now. Before, I feel like when the natural community just got started, brands made an effort to really have their stuff to be natural from end to end. But now they're just throwing some organic stuff and then throwing a bunch of chemicals at the back and just try to sell you a lower quality product with a couple of buzz ingredients. Not to say we have to leave it in 2020, but I would love to see more new botanical gels in 2021. Like, that's just my personal desire, and have more high quality products as options, at least for your customers, because we would buy them. Sometimes I've even seen even worse than some companies that they make botanical gels that they market to type 3 hair, and then they stick the plastics in the type 4 hair products. So they're pretty much saying if you have type 4 hair, you need some carbomer to hold your hair, and you don't deserve like a higher quality option. So I just find it kind of insulting and kind of infuriating to even see some of them have botanical gels, but they don't have them with a stronghold. Like, it's possible, to do a botanical gel with a strong enough hold for type 4 hair. Uncle Funky's daughter managed it, Kinky Curly managed it. I think that's why people started buying from natural hair companies in the first place, because the products marketed to black women were subpar, were more dangerous, were lower quality. So don't do that to us again. Like, that really hurts my feelings to see black women doing that to other black women. I make botanical gels and they hold type 4 hair, so don't come and tell me it's not possible, blah blah blah. I think we've lost the message a bit in terms of having higher quality options. Like I said, nothing against Kabam, I don't mind having that as an option, but there should be a botanical option for all. Everyone should have access to a botanical option if that's what they want. The other thing I still see some brands doing is not listing their full ingredient list, and then they have the nerve to get mad at people who ask for it. That's definitely something I want to see left in 2020, especially if you're not even listing the preservatives, the irritants, the allergens. At the very least, list your preservatives, list all the allergens, and list all the irritants in your product, like at the very least. And if you're not doing that, at least have it on hand so if somebody asks, you can give it to them. Actually, refusing to give a customer the full ingredients list on a product is ridiculous and illegal. And lying and saying that the product label has the full ingredients list when it has no preservative, you have all sorts of waters and fruits in there with no preservative, shelf life of 12 months, and you're trying to tell people that that's the full ingredients list. People aren't stupid. You all need to cut that mess out. You're very lucky that you're playing with the right one, because the wrong one would report you to the FDA and let them sort it out, and you'll be the one crying how unfair it is, and you'll be the one blocking people off of social media, and like, just avoid all that drama by being professional now. So first of all, get it together and start listing your full ingredients list, and second of all, get it together with your customer service. I think the biggest one for everybody is customer service. We've been really relaxed so far. Oh, it's a small company, you know, they're working hard, they don't have time to respond to emails and stuff. We've been like letting that slide. I've been defending y'all, but is it really right? Like, is it right that people can send emails and ask questions and not get responses? Is it right that people can receive their package with items missing and not get a response from you right away, or even an explanation, or even like you're charging them for everything and not putting everything with no explanation, and you're charging the full amount and then you're not even responding to the emails? Those things are not right. I feel like when somebody buys a product, they're also paying for customer service. So when you're charging a certain amount of money and customer service is not included, I do feel like if you're robbing them. And I do feel like you should probably sell fewer items on Black Friday or whenever. You should probably sell fewer items at a time so that you can properly handle your customers. And I know some of you all will be like, we gotta live too and stuff, which is fair. But if you feel like you have to live, raise your price. Raise your price so that it includes customer service and hire someone. But it's just not right to just ignore people's emails or not respond in time and so on. It's not right to just not even bother with customer service. And I've seen too many natural hair companies doing that. Please, let's leave that in 2020. We don't want that in 2021. Do better. Figure it out. Raise your price and be transparent that this is my price with customer service, so people know they're going to get customer service, because it's really not fair. Don't have new sales before you finish processing customers from your old sale. Like, that's an easy way to piss people off. Again, more customer service and focus on giving the best that you can and a good service to your existing customers, people that you're dealing with now, before you get a whole bunch of new orders. And I'm not calling any names. I just know that I've heard that some brands do that, and it's just not right. It's not professional for you to be taking a bunch of new orders and you haven't sorted through your backlog from months ago. Like, I don't really think that's right. Let's just call a spade a spade. Usually I defend you all, and this is all with love. Let's try to do better for 2021. If somebody gets their product broken and you want to give attitude, you want to challenge them. I had a case where I got a broken product and I told the owner, and she literally sent me a half bottle of replacement. So basically she's saying, well, you could probably get some from the bottom of that broken one, just take this half. That was the pettiest, most unprofessional, most disrespectful experience I ever had in my life. Needless to say, I never bought from them again. If you wanna be a business owner, you have to leave the petty behind, leave the unprofessional behind. Leave that kind of behavior behind and start to walk upright. That's all I can say about that. Besides the fact that I'm never buying from them ever again, and I'm never reviewing anything from them ever again. Don't treat customers like that. Just that little bit of petty, you save like $2-$3 and you lost hundreds of dollars from me and from whoever else saw and was equally appalled. So why? That kind of lack of home training that translates to your character as an adult and then translates into your business practices. It's unnecessary, unnecessary stuff. Treat your customers right. I still get hurt thinking about that. I still, and that happened like years ago, and I still get hurt because I was just so like stunned. Like, I've never seen anybody do that. Like, they literally sent me a half empty bottle of product. Like, who does that? Who does that? I really should have like taken them to the Better Business Bureau or something. I shouldn't have accepted that. I just kind of chalked up the L, but the person I am now would not have accepted that kind of treatment. I would have gotten my refund. And a simple one, it could be simple again until the feds come for you. Don't have promotions and then not announce the winner. And you're on social media and you're posting all kind of thing, but the deadline for the winner passed and nobody's seen a winner. That's called a scam. Of course, like social media, like you're not really paying anything. You're just tagging some people and liking a photo, but it still is not a good look and unprofessional. It's an easy way to piss off your customers, past and present and future. So just simple things like that. You have a giveaway, give away the thing. And if it's a thing of like you announced it but you didn't announce it properly, put it properly on your page exactly how you put the giveaway. Put the winner so that everybody can see it, either on the same post or on a new post. Thing to leave in 2020 that we've been letting you all get away with way too long is dishonesty. Some of you all need to be honest. Stop deleting reviews. Stop blocking customers who leave criticisms or questions on your profile. Like, that's not really the way to handle it. I've seen some brands come in and like, okay, DM me, we'll discuss. That's how you handle it. You don't handle it by just deleting and blocking. Because people aren't stupid. If I go to a site and all the reviews are like positive and 5-star, not even a 3 or 2 anywhere in the whole entire site, I know you're lying. I know you're deleting reviews. People aren't stupid. So why would you do that kind of unprofessional stuff? Like, just don't, stop doing it. If you're like deleting and blocking people, guess what? They're gonna tell 10, 20 people that you're deleting and blocking them. It's gonna get around, people are gonna know. And I know a lot of people are just like you and don't care and don't have any kind of character and be like, oh, I'ma still buy, I'ma still do it. I don't care, I like the products, I don't care who they step on, I don't care who they wrong. But there are other people out there who are gonna care and who are gonna stop dealing with brands that mistreat customers, mistreat influencers, and so on. So be honest, don't be those people, don't be that kind of person, don't be that kind of brand, basically. Honesty, fair play, loyalty, gratitude, humility. Like, there's a whole list of virtues that seem to be missing in certain people. And another thing we need to leave in 2020 is marketing to self-hate, texturism, insecurities. I want to see brands stop doing that. We don't need to see before be kinky looking hair and after be sleek looking hair, or after be loose defined curls and stuff. Like, type 4 hair shouldn't be a before. Like, your natural curl pattern shouldn't be a before. Shouldn't be a like, oh, this is a hot mess because it's looking kinky, and oh, I put it in some kind of permalad or smoothen it out somehow. It's silky now, so it's looking good. I really like those ads. I'm really sick of seeing them, and I really hope that they go away. Some of them even like have girls with looser curls and then they comb out the hair and like shake it up to try to make it look as kinky as possible, and then they wash with the product and all of a sudden it's loose. So trying to kind of imply that your products fix or tame or change kinky hair, I just don't like that kind of marketing. How about somebody who had like a really nice style before and then she had like a really nice different style after with your product? I mean, that works, right? You don't have to change it from kinky to silky every single time. Maybe the after could be a nice afro. Maybe the after could be nice cornrows. Like, it doesn't have to be some kind of smoothed out, silked out, or defined style every single time for the after. You've made all this money from the natural hair community. Even though you can say, well, you're giving people what they want, you've made so much money from us. I think the way to give back is to give us back our confidence and our love and appreciation for our hair and for all the diverse types of natural hair. Giving those who want to embrace their kinks, giving those who want to embrace their untransformed natural hair that opportunity and that showcase and that highlight, and even trying to maybe expand the number of people who accept their hair as is, because it's not somebody's before image in every single ad. So if we could not normalize curls and sleekness and shine so much in 2021, that'd be great. If we could leave that in 2020, that'd be great. For 2021, let the afros, let the cornrows, let the variety of natural hair shine pretty much, and normalize diversity pretty much. Can't believe we need diversity in the natural hair movement, but let's normalize that for 2021. Instead of bottling curls or selling products to get curls, tell me which products give me the best afro. Tell me which products give me the best cane rows or mini twists or cornrows. So that's my list. I know I didn't get everything, so definitely let me know in the comments, or let us know in the comments, what other behaviors, what else brands need to leave in 2020, and what you want to see from brands in 2021. Let's chat down in the comments. We are the customers. We are the influencers. We want to have a good relationship with brands, and it is a relationship, and they need to do their part as well. So thanks for watching. Happy New Year. See you in 2021. Bye.